Hey guys, Jeff here from Adirondack Woodsman. As you saw yesterday, I picked up my 1222 splitter from Easton Made, and today we're going to christen it and put it to the test. So follow along, and if you enjoy this, let me know. Couple things. First thing I'm going to do is this stem is actually removable, so you can take it out, so discouraging theft. But what I got to do is put it back in now, and so I can get it out of here, tow it out of here. I just don't remember where, how far back it is. I think it's probably easier just do it from down here so I can actually see it. So one thing you'll notice is that the tray is extra long. That's an option I actually paid to have done. And the idea is that I can work on the wood a little bit if I need to bring pieces back or whatever, depending upon what's going on. The only downside is I probably have to take the tray off to be able to see under here real good. So he said the tray is pinned in too. I'm not sure where the pin is on it. Oh, I see it now. We'll slide the tray out in order to be able to get at it. I think I'm going to get a screwdriver. Try to pry it. There we go. See that now. Oh, almost there. Just gotta come back my way a little bit. Probably too far. The box wedge kind of gets in the way of visibility here. Okay, now just snap it in. Locked in. Put the tray back. There we go. Man, that spring is tight. I think one thing that I'm going to do is put a block in behind where I want this to end up when I put it back, so I don't push it too far. You know, I might need to look at a picture here. I don't want to put this thing on wrong. Okay, so fortunately Andrew had a nice video on how to put this on. It goes like this, upside down. Go. Okay. I think that's good. Okay, let's go park this sucker. I'm gonna get a second IBC tote for offcuts. Okay, so before we get started, I'm gonna kind of show you what we have here with the Easter-Made 1222. I bought three extra wedges. It comes standard with the six-way wedge. I bought a seven-way box wedge. I bought the four-way for doing, you know, any very large rounds that are kind of gnarly. And then I also bought the pizza wedge, which I had them put in to the into the actual unit, because I have a bunch of ash rounds here that were cut in the spring, and I want to run them through the pizza wedge and see how well it handles them. I probably won't be using this for any, you know, for most of my other wood, but for doing bundling wood, hopefully this will work out well. So gotta check all the things like the gas, check the oil, which already was checked, but get these covers off the totes. This one here's got a little bit of snow in it from a couple days ago. And I'm gonna do the bundle wood in this one so I can be close to it. So I'll throw the few offcuts I got now into there. It's kind of a weird dipstick. I'm gonna have to read the manual and see how much I'm supposed to have up to. Normally they got hash marks on the dipsticks, but this one doesn't. It's got one very small range there. So I want to look and see too if there's an hour meter on this thing. I believe there is, but just want to find it. Might need to put an IR meter on this thing. Check the fuel too. See how much fuel we get. They probably didn't fill it up, so I'm guessing. I think what we're going to do is burn what's in there, and then we'll put some new fuel in afterwards. I'm sure they've started it up once or twice. Okay, let me go get the keys and we can turn this on. Okay, so let's get this thing started up for the first time, guys, and we'll see how it runs. So I'm gonna let it warm up a little bit first. I think I gotta turn it this way. Of course, I'm starting right with the one that's got a big knot in the middle. Oh well. Okay. Coming over here to see how high the wedges are. Well, let's give it a shot, guys. I'm so used to pulling back to have the wood come, have the wedge return back. On this one, they both go forward and then they auto retract. So this is actually pretty nice. This is nicer than what I thought it was going to come out. So I think what I'm going to do is split a few. Some of these I have to put through again, but that's okay. Okay, so I ran into one issue where while I was adjusting the wedge, I obviously adjusted it too far down. I'm going to give you a look here. So Shai ran into this too, I remember. If you're not careful and you put the wedge too low, then... So Shai noticed that if you go too low with the wedge, this doesn't line up anymore. So I've got to, I believe, raise the wedge up so I can get that aligned again. So I'm not as strong as Shai, so I'm gonna be able to lift 250 pounds by myself, but or 200 pounds. So I'm gonna go get a jack, I think, to put underneath that and see if I can lift it up that way. Actually, I think I'm gonna use the forks. So that took me a little while to figure out how to fix it. Basically, this blue thing here, the orange wedge was on this side of the blue thing. I'm not quite sure how it got that. I guess the wood's just lifting up to the point where somehow it gets bound. So what I had against here, I put this on the back side, this on the back side of the blue part, and I put a board right here. I put a board here, and I was able to, I didn't have enough clamping pressure. I was able to clamp it some, but then what I did was once I had it on there, I pushed like this, and I didn't want to break my clamp, but I had to do it a couple times, and then it popped back in. So I think the answer is not to have it go all the way down. You're supposed to have this blue lifting piece in the notch some. So I'm going to try to see if I can lift it up a little bit and prevent that from happening.
Out of gas.
Okay guys, so we got almost a full tote split. Certainly not a record setting pace. I'm still kind of learning, and some of these big rounds are kind of knotty, so not exactly made for the pizza wedge. But in any case, I've got quite a bit of wood that I can use for bundling. I probably still gotta go through a little bit more. I'm trying to avoid the resplits if I can. And over there, you can see I've got some for my wood furnace. So, but all in all, I think it was a good first run with the 1222. And the only thing that I had an issue with it early on, but once again, just keeping an eye on it, is you want to make sure that the wedge is latched in there. If you get it down too low, it can come out when there's pressure up against the wedge. So that's probably the only thing that I ran into that I had an issue with. So anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video. There'll be a lot more coming this year. Like I said, over in the distance, you can probably see I got my conveyor. At some point, we'll get that set up. What that does is it also takes out all this stuff. I got grizzly bars on it, and it'll take all of the junk out so you can catch it so that you don't end up with that in your totes or in your bags, log lift bags, if you end up using them. So, but anyways, thanks for watching. I hope you guys have a great day, and if you haven't already, go ahead and hit subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and leave me a comment. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.